Good evening, I'm Kurt Gugsell. Forest Park girls soccer picked up a 2-0 win over Pike Central in the regional semifinal. Last night at Pike Central, Riley Henson and Paige Memmer found the back of the net for the Rangers. Forest Park will play Providence in the regional final on Saturday. Northeast Dubois boys soccer taking on White River Valley tonight in Northeast Dubois. Jasper boys tennis back in the state finals. Jasper will play Noblesville in a state quarterfinal tomorrow morning. It will be the Cats' 17th finals appearance in 7 times in the last 10 seasons. Wildcat coach Scott Yarbrough on how this team got to this point.
So the first thing we have coming back from last year is we have a lot of experience. So we returned 6 of our 7 guys from last year's team that was in the Final Four. So we are, we're deep, and we return a lot of guys from last year's team. And then on top of that, Braxton Brosmer, who was a varsity player for us 2 years ago, was injured last year, and he's back this year. So even a little bit more experience there. So I'd say the one thing that's probably stands out this team as much as any is just as much experience as we have and all the guys and the matches that we've played last season and this season. It's probably the one thing that I think has helped us through this season as much as possible.
When you look back on making another trip, and how have you been able to do this for so long?
You know, the one thing, I think the head coach gets a lot of times way too much credit. And I mean that honestly. We have a lot of good people that help us with our program. Our summer program, everybody asks where this begins. And I think it's our summer tennis camp. I think we had over 250 kids again at camp. We've got some great people that come in and help. Ray Smiley, Ray's been with us now for almost 10 years. He's our head tennis pro. Dan Fair has been a coach with me now for 14, 15 years. Evan Elrod, Jeff Hayes has moved back. So we have a lot of guys in this program that know tennis, which is a sport that not everybody knows. And not only that, we've kept the staff together. So I think you've got some consistency there, a lot of people pitching in. We've got some local guys that in the summer love hitting with our kids. And then we've got kids that are dedicated. We've got kids that put in the time. We've got a mix. This is probably a team that's got as many multi-sport athletes that we've had in a while, but it's a team that's managed to put it together. And year in and year out, we seem to reload pretty quick. And I'm going to give a lot of credit to just to the support of the families and the things that we do with the junior program and the summer program that was established well before I got here.
Speaking of well before you got here, what would your dad think about all this? We had the thing at the Calumet, you know, honoring those first teams and how it started. What would he think about all this?
I you know, the one thing Dad was more than anything was he was a Jasper Wildcat. He was excited. He loved coaching here. He loved teaching here. He loved teaching. He took his teaching and put it into his coaching. Yeah. He did, for those of him don't know, he did some football. He did some pole vaulting coaching. He was a basketball coach for a while. But in his heart and soul, his last 10 to 12 years really poured into this tennis program. A lot of the things that we have are because of him. The facility we play at is because of him. The Hall of Fame and everything that goes into that and the kids, what they're doing today and this indoor facility that we have. I think he would be more than just flabbergasted by the fact that what we've pulled off, at least at Jasper High School. And he'd be very proud of where the program is today.
Scout your opponent on Friday.
Yeah. So very familiar, only because we played him last year. So for those people that don't know, there's 8 semi-state winners. And then it's a pull of the hat. I mean, it's random draw.
Yeah.
I think the draw is pretty fair. You've got a 2 or 3 of the top 10 teams on the left side of the draw, 2 or 3 teams on the right side, top 10. We draw Noblesville. We're going to have some similar matchups to last year. So they graduated, I want to say, 3 kids.
Yeah.
So they're 1 singles players back, and they're 3 singles players back. So we'll know a little bit about them now. We lost our 1 singles player, Trey Cooksell. So Joel will move up and play 1. And I think Elliot at 2 singles will actually end up playing the same kid he played last year. We'll have a new 3 singles player, and they'll have a new one. I've got a couple nice scouting reports. Coaches in tennis usually share information. They graduated their 1 doubles, but their 2 doubles has moved up, and from what I understand, playing really well. And then they got a new 2 doubles team. So, you know, I think it'll be a really good match. We get this, and then here's what they're doing at the state finals. It's different. So North Central, where the state finals was for years, completely redid their tennis facility. So all 4 matches on Friday will be at North Central. So it'd be pretty cool to have all 4 matches. The last 7 or 8 years, it's been split. Some have been at Center Grove, some have been at Carmel. So, but this year, all 4 matches on Friday, and it'll be at 10 a.m. It's going to be in the morning. We'll go up Thursday night and get ready to go.
Cats and Millers tomorrow at North Central again at 10 a.m. The Colts still banged up entering the 7th week of the season. Josh Downs, Ryan Kelly, Chris Lamones, Dale Odingbo, Michael Pittman Jr., Trey Sermon, Braden Smith, and E.J. Speed, along with Jonathan Taylor, did not practice yesterday. Quarterback Anthony Richardson listed as a full participant. Indy at 3-3, hosting the Dolphins at Lucas Oil Stadium on Sunday. The Thursday night game will feature the Broncos in New Orleans taking on the Saints. Pacers close down the preseason tonight. They're at home at the Fieldhouse against Charlotte. Stay tuned. We'll have more right after this.